Just nipping on, because we'd watched an interesting interview between Tash Archaeo and Dr Chloe Duckworth. They were talking about recycling in Roman glass and general recycling. So Graham's been working on an interesting pot, an Anglo-Saxon pot, which uses recycled Roman glass. So he was just going to quickly show you.
Hi. What I'm working on is what's known as the Kempston window urn, and it is indeed an Anglo-Saxon pot, but it's rather an exotically shaped Anglo-Saxon pot. It has these 14 wonderful ribs down at the bottom here, which give this beautiful base. But most interesting of all is in the very bottom, there is a inset piece of glass. Now, this is, as I say, it's known as the Kempston window urn. And the reason it's known as a window urn is it's got a little window in it. It's not unusual in Anglo-Saxon pots. There have been quite a few of them done now. And a gentleman contacted me a few years ago who was doing his PhD on them. The thing about the piece of glass in there is, in the original, it's a piece of Roman glass. So it's the Anglo-Saxons in probably something like the 5th or 6th century picking up bits of broken Roman glass and reusing them and insetting them into the bottom. Now, it's a piece of turquoise glass. The first one I made of these, I fired in an open firing, as undoubtedly the Anglo-Saxons would have done. Therefore, it's getting up to probably about 700-800 degrees centigrade, but in a strongly reducing atmosphere, so not much oxygen in there. And the effect that had was it slightly melted the piece of turquoise glass, which was obviously coloured with copper, because what it did was it drew some of that copper to the surface, and in the reducing atmosphere turned it to metallic copper. So once it cooled down, it had the remarkable feature of, if you looked at an angle with the reflected light, you got red, and if you held it up to the light, you probably see that you're getting some light through there, and what you get is a greenish turquoise light, and that was the case in the original. So I'm going to see if this does the same when we fire it, whether we get that wonderful effect. And if you go and look at Bedford Museum collections, you'll find this one there. It's a lovely pot.